The call to enact the laws to operationalize Islamic banking in Uganda for 1 year was made by Sifas Birunji, a tax expert who represented Ugandan Law Society to Parliament's Finance Committee that is considering four tax bills, including the Income Tax Amendment Bill, Stamp Duty Amendment Bill, Excise Duty Amendment Bill, and Value Added Tax Amendment Bill that are intended to streamline the operationalization of Islamic banking in Uganda.
To bring these amendments after the main amendments, which are traditional before October, which come in April, appear to be a tactical risk.
The Uganda Law Society asked Parliament to halt enactment of the laws on Islamic banking for 1 year to allow stakeholders to understand the concepts instead of ambushing the public, and asked Parliament to inquire from Uganda Revenue Authority about their preparedness to tax Islamic banking.
Because now when you are introduced to many aspects of Sharia law which you need to understand and conceptualize, I think you are kind of being ambushed into saying, this thing is complicated, let's just allow it.
Lawyers want Parliament to enact separate laws to govern Islamic banking instead of mixing them with the laws governing the conventional financial sector.
The whole Islamic taxation regime could have could be separate from VAT to income tax to stamp duty. All these, once you are reading them by just amending provisions of the law, you are creating a confusion.
Birunji cited confusion in the Value Added Tax Amendment Bill 2023 and the Income Tax Amendment Bill No. 2, 2023, saying the proposals from the government are likely to pose complications in the financial sector.
It is more problematic. VAT is just three-dimensional. Sale, input, and exemptions. Income tax is much more complicated.
Under Islamic financial business, we do not anywhere consider what they call interest. It is about profit and, you know,
sharing, partnership.
Yes.
Yeah. Amos Kakunda, the chairperson of the Finance Committee, however, defended the enactment of laws to govern Islamic banking, arguing that it is intended to spur the economy by giving the business community another financing option.
And most of the business and players in the private sector are looking at Islamic financing as another source that will help them to revamp.
Committee members decried the limited time of 1 week that the Finance Committee was given to process the bills, saying they need more time to consult all stakeholders.
So it becomes a little bit difficult, Honorable Chair, hopefully that this will be the last time that we are doing things in a hurry, because at the end of the day, we shall produce reports well, but they will be half-baked.
Eh? Once passed, of course, they will have an implication to do with the revenue.
If amendments at hand are passed into law, Uganda will join other African countries that have adopted Islamic banking but are non-Islamic states, including South Africa, Senegal, Botswana, Zambia, Eritrea, Mozambique, Kenya, Tanzania, and Rwanda. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.